and they didn't play them. It was a close game rather last week, so it should be a very interesting game tonight as both teams will have a chance to adjust.
A week ago tonight, as you mentioned, Mark, the UOIT Ridgebacks were here at the Columbia Icefields and lost 3-2 to the host Warriors. And right off the bat, the Warriors into the attacking zone. This is Chris Ray. Puck up high. Tyler Moyer took a swat at that. Tried to put that on goal to Jason Guy. He started here last week. He was spectacular. The Warriors had close to 40 shots in that game. Up along the boards, knocked down by Ray. Kept it along the half boards. Congregation of players there now. Three for each club. Schwendy comes away with it. Moyer tried to poke that one in, but it's skated out to center ice by Josh Battery. He's got Rizzi with him. Rizzi's long wrist shot right into the chest of Hartigan, but offside is the call.
Yeah, as you mentioned, Guy led the show for the Ridgebacks last week, and they'll look to him to make some big saves again tonight. I'm sure they'll have to. Those Warriors with a very potent offense, so they'll need him again this game and look to get their offense, look to get some physical bodies in on these Warriors early on.
Right away, a turnover in the Warriors' zone, but it's knocked away, and Kurt Thorner comes away with it. Hand pass is the call in the neutral zone. Face off in the neutral zone, bit of a disjointed start, still under a minute played here in the first period. Face off, Connors, he was not in the lineup. Bounce off the end boards, Whalen was there. And again, it slides to the side and covered up by Keaton Hartigan. A few plays, we see the Ridgebacks trying to work down low behind the goal line. They maybe saw something on tape from Keaton Hartigan last weekend against Laurier. He had one goal scored on a wraparound and had a few more opportunities as close calls. And perhaps they've picked something up. Face off to the left of Keaton Hartigan. Captain Nathan Spaulding, brother of Nashville Predators center Nick Spaulding. Ray is waved out of the draw. Excuse me, that was Frazier waved out. Cardiff will take it. Round back of the net. First one there is Baker for the Ridgebacks. Couldn't engage the cycle. Frazier behind his own goal line. Flips it out to center ice. And Cardiff will dump that one in to the opposite corner. Guy tries to play that away from the oncoming forecheck. Able to do so. Back to center ice it comes. Ryan Molly to Sonnenberg. Ryan Molly scored his first career CIS goal against the Laurier Golden Hawks last Saturday night. Pass there to Frazier. High over the glass and out of play. Almost joined us up here in the booth.
Good shift. A few good bodies there by the energy line. Coach Burke elects not to start with this energy line, which he does on occasion, but rather with the Ray line tonight. And they go in and have a good offensive shift. It'll be interesting to see who the Ridgebacks want to put against this Ray line or if they even try to match up at all tonight.
Purvis to center ice. Move at the line by Montgomery. That was a nice move, but he had nobody on the far side. Now a bounce pass. Schappert was behind a defenseman. Couldn't get the pass, though. Steffes across to Steve Whiteley. Up ahead to Andy Smith. Smith scored a gorgeous goal against the Ridgebacks to open the scoring last Friday night. On a rush, he went top shelf, beating two men to a loose puck. It was tapped ahead by Tyler Moyer. Greg Steffes behind his own net, setting up the breakout. And once again, as we saw last weekend, a passive forecheck from UOIT. Feather pass right in front. Tipped by his own man, but Guy put a pad on it. Covered. Four whistle. 17:28 remaining first period.
A really excellent execution there by the Warriors. Just a great, great passing play coming out. And it's subtle. It's not something you notice, but it gets them all the way down the ice and gets a chance on goaltender Guy. Just good movement by the defenders and making good decisions coming out of their end.
Face off. One by Ray. Bounce pass in front. A jam play there off the lively end boards, and Guy didn't leave his post. Now through his own zone comes Bagshaw. He's got Rizzi. Rizzi's shot kicked away by Hartigan. Ryan Molly behind his own net. to the empty wing. Noyes smacks that back into the corner. And back out to Tyler Moyer. Through center ice come the Warriors now. That's Kyle Schwendy. Schwendy to Ray. Ray tried to pick that one up. He's buried by Noyes. A little slow getting up. Pass back to Colin Cowardine. Schwendy, he couldn't handle that pass. Fluttered through his legs. Bouncing puck. Both teams are having a little bit of a difficulty corralling it at this point. Mike Noyes, he'll just calm the play down as the Warriors go off for a change. This is Sean Connors. Pass through center ice, Whalen in by himself. His shot short side just missed. Moyer now flips it high in the length of the ice. Down to Mike Legg, who touches up the puck. I think there'll be a UOIT penalty. It'll be a charge to Jeremy Whalen. So the Warriors will get the first power play opportunity of the game.
Yeah, Whalen trying to spark his team there, get in on the offensive zone on these Warriors and lay the body, but perhaps a little bit too overzealous, and the referee calls him for charging. A big opportunity here with 16-13 early in this game for this Warrior team to go up. It'll be a very big kill here for this UOIT Ridgeback team as they have a little bit of confusion on their bench about who they want to put out.
So the Warriors with 16-13 left in this first period has the first chance on the power play. Faceoff retrieved. Smith back to the point. Whiteley to Sonnenberg. Off the boards. Almost hopped over his stick. Kept it in. Another one off the end board. Bounced right to the side of the net. Guy knocked that one away. And Spalling to the line and out to the neutral zone. Now quick pass Smith. Two on one. Smith in front. Back pass to Shepard. Couldn't convert. Purvis got a stick on it. Now backdoor play. Thorner was there. The pass was behind him. Sonnenberg tried to tip it ahead. Bounced right back to center ice by Purvis. Chris Purvis with some good work on the penalty kill. Now Smith sets up a man again. It's Shepard. Backhander stop. Big save by Guy. The rebound. Shepard is there. Scores! Josh Shepard on the rebound. Draws first blood and it's 1-0 Warriors.
Well, Shepard with the first opportunity alone in front with great patience there. Tries to outwait Guy, but Guy stays with him and gets the right pad on it. And the puck is left in front. The UIOT Ridgeback's not able to get at that puck. Shepard with left with about a second or two to look at that net there and pick a spot, and he did so on the blocker side. And Warriors were able to get that lead that they were looking for. Great job by the Warriors power play, and this UIOT Ridgeback team will have to battle back here early.
Shepard showed great patience on the setup from Smith. Holding it on the backhand, didn't get it up as high as he wanted to. A sprawling save, but again, more time on the second opportunity. And he passed that one. Right back on the forecheck is the Warriors with the energy line. That's Basie, Frazier, and Cardiff. Through center ice, Oliver knocked that one back in. And Morkirk, he tried to reach that one, didn't connect. Flip back into the Warriors zone, and it's Sonnenberg. Tavasi on the far wing. His pass just out of the reach of Frazier. Flipped all the way back in, and Sonnenberg, who played a ton of hockey last weekend, in both games last weekend, the Warriors went with five defensemen due to injuries. Aaron Delio is still out with a knee injury. Keelan Wong drew back in today. So the Warriors are up to 60 men as they ice the puck.
Yeah, asking a lot of the veteran guys, and that's where you got to lean on a guy like Sonnenberg, who is a fourth-year guy in this team that a lot of players look up to and one of their better players. And with a player like Delio out, a fifth-year veteran, they really have to lean on those guys and depend on them.
Face off to the right of Keaton Hartigan, won by the Ridgebacks. Purvis, his quick shot. That one was kicked away. Don't know if Rizzi got a stick on that. He was right there on the doorstep. Digging forward in the corner now, comes to Connors at the point. Fires that one back and calmly played to Schwendy on the half boards by Hartigan, but misplayed there by Schwendy and it was sent just wide. Centering feed opportunity there. Cowardine knocked that one away over the glass and out of play. The Waterloo Warriors currently sitting in fourth place in the OUA Western Conference with a record of 13-8-0, good for 26 points. Just 1 point behind Lakehead. 3 behind Laurier with a game in hand on the Golden Hawks. UOIT currently sits 6th, 9-9-4 record, 22 points. Still only 4 points separating these two teams, though. Obviously, every game is a big one at this point in the season, especially for two teams this close together in the standings. To the line, backhanded in, knocked down by Whiteley. Whiteley will set it up there for Greg Steffes. Now Forner hits center ice, dumps it down, has Lewicki streaking. Hill on the forecheck. That one's played calmly away by Purvis. Up to Whalen. Whalen drags through. Big move up top. Just missed the top corner. A beautiful move splitting the defenseman. Whalen just missed the top half of the net. Jeremy Whalen may be trying to make amends for the charging penalty that led to the Warriors' first power play goal. Cross ice pass for Frazier out of his reach. Bounces to TJ Legg. Frazier lays a body on Legg. Loose puck now. Oliver was close to the first one there. Couldn't reach it. Deflected back into the Warriors' zone. Whiteley. Long flip play. First one there is Barletta. Ref Barletta sets it up for Legg. Legg, the length of the ice. Missed a man on a pass. Icing is the call. 12:51 remaining. First period. The Warriors still lead 1-0.
Good effort by Whalen now on that last play, recognizing that he had the defenseman beat and gets a great shot, a great chance on net there from point blank. That's a good effort for him, perhaps, as he said, trying to make amends for the penalty, but in any case, trying to get some offense of any kind for this Ridgeback team early in this game.
Face off, scrambled, Baker knocks it back to Spalling. Noise now, plays that one up, knocked out of the zone by Brendan Wise. Through center ice comes Wise with Spalling. Turned right back by the Warriors. Passed over. Dumps that one down. Sonnenberg retrieves it. Given away now. In front. Baker just missed that conversion. The pass was there for him and it was just out of his reach. Didn't connect. Uncharacteristic turnover there by Kyle Sonnenberg. Almost led to the equalizer. Warriors just trying to calm the play down. Sonnenberg skates it out of his own zone. Hill chips it in. We'll go for a change as we hit the 8-minute mark of the first period. And this is Bagshaw. He's knocked off stride. Now Schwendy. He's got Ray streaking in the net. Schwendy, Ray tipped it just out of his reach. He did get a stick on it. Good save by Guy. Now a shot. Another one blocked by Pastore. Sonnenberg's blast. That hit him on the knee. Now Vatry the other way. Vatry tries to stick handle through a crowd. Schwendy takes him into the boards hard. Leaves the puck there for Ryan Molly. Molly hits center ice, dumps it in. Tyler Moyer's the first one there. Schwendy, he hits his man hard. Forces the turnover and a shot from the sideboards at a sharp angle. Schwendy going after the loose puck now. Kyle Schwendy showing all kinds of legs early on. Whiteley with a good move. His shot just wide off the end boards. Schwendy is there again. First one of the loose puck. Now Ray tries to work his way in front of the net. Spins off a man. Drops it back to the pinching Whiteley. Whiteley now in behind the net. Waits for a man. In front. Centered it. Bounced off a stick. Now back to Cowardine. Cowardine winds and fires. That one hit a leg in front. Just wide and out the other end it comes. The Warriors carrying the play in this first period. Touch pass there to Shepard. He's the goal scorer. Shepard tries to center it to Smith. Smith steps around a loose stick. And the Ridgebacks on their heels. Puck in the feet of Montgomery. Finally bounces up to center ice. But right back into the Warrior zone. Into the UOIT zone, excuse me. And it's Chartier. Shot in front. They score! Andy Smith converts the beautiful pass by Blake Chartier. And it's 2-0 Warriors.
Outstanding sequence by the Warriors there. Really great couple of shifts. Started off by the Ray line, just having fantastic possession, wearing down defenders in the offensive zone, and weren't able to capitalize with a goal, but then the Smith line comes out and able to do so with a really great poke check there by Shepard to start that play, but it's just It's the whole team buying in on this. A couple of great shifts there of players getting to pucks and beating the Ridgeback defenders. I think Coach Burke will be happy with the last couple of shifts and will want his team to continue this onslaught.
Looks like it'll be an early timeout call for the UOIT Ridgebacks. They need to settle their club down. Obviously, the Warriors only up 2-0. The game isn't out of hand, but certainly, you mentioned it, Mark, the last two or three shifts, certainly the great deal of time spent in the Ridgeback zone. And finally able to convert was Andy Smith's line. They've got both goals thus far, and Blake Chartier made a beautiful pass in front to Smith.
Yeah, I think this is a good call by the Ridgeback coach. Just trying to settle the squad down. In the last couple of shifts there, it wasn't just that the Warriors were in the offensive zone. It just seemed that the Ridgeback players were getting beat to pucks, and that's something that as a coach you don't want to see, and as a players on the bench, you don't want to see your guys getting beat to pucks, even if the other team is perhaps a little more skilled, arguably. So that'll be the goal for these guys, to try to catch up a little bit in terms.
Whip back into the UOIT zone. Chartier circles and looks again. Dropped it back to the streaking Sonnenberg. Shepard and Chartier get the assist on Andy Smith's goal. To the line, Sonnenberg jumps up, keeps it in. Spins off a check, straddles the line. In front, tip. Chartier tipped that one right on, and Guy had to be sharp to kick that out. Shepard, the timeout did not seem to work. The Warriors continue to apply the pressure. Sonnenberg on the wraparound in front, far post. The puck bounces right to Guy. He'll cover up for a whistle. Mark, the Ridgebacks, as you mentioned, it's something they just need to do to settle this down and try to stop the Warrior onslaught. Although they're sixth in the conference, they have given up the most goals, tied for the most goals given up in the conference with York at 82. So they win close games and they lose ones that get a little out of hand, and I think that's what they were trying to prevent. Astor spins off a check. Baker drops it for Spalling. Pass Baker at the line. Pastor picks it up. Through the neutral zone. Spalling tips it in. Right to Keaton Hardigan. Hardigan up to Frazier. Frazier's got Vasey. He'll tap it in and Cardiff will be the first one there. He engages Pastor. Vasey comes in there on the forecheck as well. To the line, not out, knocked down by Molly. Slaps it back in and Baker sets that one up to Pastor. Matt Pastor plays it up to center ice where Colin Carradine gathers it for the Warriors. Long flipping up over the glass and out of play. Faceoff will come all the way back down into the Warriors' zone.
Well, Adam, one play I'd like to keep watching throughout this game and see if the Ridgebacks are able to pick it up. It's I've seen it a few times and it's been very effective is the exchange between the winger and the defenseman as the Waterloo offensive players cycle the puck, they're able to give it to the defenseman who pinches in. It's either Sonnenberg or Whiteley usually, and it's been incredibly effective for them so far, and it's confused this Ridgeback team.
Up to center ice now. Tipped past Powerdine, but Battery couldn't reach it. Now Ray. Down to Moyer. See if the Warriors engage the cycle. As you mentioned, Mark, the cycle extremely effective, and the Warriors with their wrinkle of pulling a defenseman off to engage in that cycle. As a wrist shot tipped just high by Schwendy. Now through the neutral zone, given away again, out of Bagshaw's reach. Turnover by the Warriors and a 2-on-2 Vatry. He waits for help. Chris Ray knocks it off of his stick. Ray goes to fetch it. Vatry was able to fend him off. Shoots it in. Hardigan stops that behind the net, and Colin Cowardine will set up the breakout. Whiteley to Hill. Knock that one down. He'll be the first one in on leg. Puts a body on him, and Thorner is there to help him out. Trying to dig a loose puck in front of the net, just wide of the net. Hill slid it just past the far post. Barletta reverses the play back to TJ Legg. He'll be contentious to flip it through center ice. Knocked down by Keelan Wong. I think this is Wong's first shift of the game. In front. It's on the goal line. Where is it? It's under Keaton Hardigan. What a tremendous save, post to post, by Keaton Hardigan.
Yeah, absolutely outstanding by Keaton Hardigan after a cold spell there. He hasn't seen a shot in how long, and he gets across to make that save. Just a quick bang-bang play by this Ridgeback team after Wong was beaten to the puck. And absolutely outstanding. That was a close one. The Ridgeback players standing on the doorstep, and the Warriors putting their sticks behind Hardigan to make sure that one didn't cross the line.
It was a bit of a look-what-I-found save. Noise at the point. Shot off the end boards in front. Stopped. Another stop by Hardigan. He's down. He covered it up. Keaton Hardigan has found his game recently, and he's certainly exhibiting it tonight.
Very impressive again. Just as I mentioned there, just very difficult for goaltenders when not having shots. You hear them always talk about that. It's more difficult when they're not getting a lot of action in their end, and he's able to make those two saves.
Baker, his shot off a leg just wide. Off a Warrior skate and a turnover. Spalling in front of the net, tipped away just at the last moment. Pastor's backhand pass crept up over the line, so Noyes has to retreat into the neutral zone. Smith turns away. Up to Sonnenberg. Sonnenberg pinches again. Sonnenberg on the rush. Sharp angle. Skates around behind the net. Sonnenberg looking for a man. Sonnenberg makes a couple of moves. Slides off his stick. And out to center ice. Couldn't find a passing lane and an open man. Sonnenberg up to Shepard. Shepard leaves it. Back to Shepard in front. Huge save. Jason Guy reaches back and robs Josh Shepard on the backhand.
Yeah, Guy says, look what I can do too here. It's outstanding again there. Great play by the Warriors, and Sonnenberg running around the ice here making plays all over the place. But a great little backdoor stab there by a guy who grabs it with a glove. Also a puck that looked like it was right on the line.
Whiteley walks the line. His wrist shot. That hit a leg on the way through. That was Connors blocking that shot. Now to Steffes. Center ice knocked in by Frazier. First one there is Chris Purvis. Starts the breakout. Ryan Oliver lifts it in. Whiteley is there. He bodies up to his man. That's Van Moorkirk. To the line. That shot is blocked. Fearlessly blocked there by Thomas Cardiff. Knocked the puck out to center ice. Schwendy leaves it there. Frazier with Vasey and Schwendy. Frazier lost that one at the blue line. Wong off the bench will knock that one right back in. Chris Ray now has a jump on Van Moorkirk, but Van Moorkirk will get to the puck first. Oliver Fan on the pass. Chris Ray now spins away from the traffic. Hits center ice. Leaves it there for Moyer. Moyer fakes the shot. In front of the net. Hit a skate. Schwendy was there. Puck loose the line. Wong had backed off of the impending rush, though. Couldn't keep it in. Now a shot the other way. That was Bagshaw. Derek Bagshaw's shot is deflected up and over the glass and out of play. 5:13 remaining, first period.
Ridgeback's able to get a few good chances there on Hardigan in the last few minutes, but other than that, it has been a fairly Warrior-dominated game here. With only 5 minutes left, you want to see this Ridgeback team try to gain some momentum, get some sustained pressure, and that would be really big for them, I think, moving forward in this game, being down two goals already.
Face-off, rung all the way to the far boards, end of the blue line, it's Pastore. He sends it right back where it came from. Battery is there with Rizzi. Tony Rizzi. Back to the line, it's Noyes. Noyes, his shot off the end boards, right in front. Hardigan freezes it with a blocker hand. Dominic Hasek style, dropping the stick, covering it up with a blocker hand for a faceoff.
Yeah, smart play by the veteran guy, Noyes, there. He saw he didn't have the lane, just tries to bank it off these boards, and I'm sure he's played here a few times, so he knows about these boards and that they can be lively. Tries to make a trick play there.
We've seen a few intentionally wide shots thus far this evening. Howard Iron. Rizzi keeps that one in at the line. Down to Battery. Battery. He's got Bagshaw. Bagshaw spins behind the net. Looks for a lane. Cycles it back to Battery. Battling there with Ryan Molly. Battery back down to Bagshaw. Rizzi. His shot. Wrist shot through the crowd. didn't get through. Bagshaw leaves it behind the net, but Molly's the first one there for the Warriors on the backhand of the line. And out. Second chance. The Warriors knocked it out. Noyes was standing pat, trying to keep the offensive pressure going for the Ridgebacks. It's been few and far between for them. Up to center ice, Ryan Molly to Sonnenberg. Excuse me, that's Whiteley. Wettering, he can't keep that one in at the line. Wettering has another chance. Turns away from Kurt Thorner. Over the line comes Wettering. Into the corner. Wettering still with it. Kyle Wettering with Kurt Hill on him. Wettering finally comes out. Tries to bowl his way in front. Knocked off stride. Took a look back, waiting for a penalty call. Didn't come. TJ Legg hits the red line, dumps it in. Hardigan tries to stop that behind the net. And up along the boards and out. Josh Schappert has Smith. Smith has wheels. We've seen this before. Smith to the outside. In front. Chartier couldn't get his stick loose. Puck bounces right bound. Schappert, his high shot. Glove save. On the short side, Schappert had a chance there. Off the boards. Whiteley jumped up, kept that one in. On the backhand, down low to Smith. Smith, he's got Chartier with him. Chartier picks it up. Here's that cycle with the D-man that you talked about, Mark. Whiteley, sharp angle shot. Through the crease, nobody was there. This Andy Smith line has looked dynamite thus far. They've accounted for both Waterloo goals and a ton of pressure. More scoring opportunities on that last shift. Now Cardiff up ahead to Basie. Basie reaches the line, dumps it in. Bagshaw lost his stick. Frazier keeps that one in, tries to center it in front. Cardiff was coasting towards the slot, couldn't reach that pass, didn't connect. And the Ridgebacks will try to slow down play now. Josh Vatry picks up the loose puck again. He's hammered into the boards by Vasey. Came at him from the side, and good stiff check knocked Vatry off the puck. Now Vasey to Frazier. Under 2 minutes now to play in this first period. The Warriors continue to lead 2-0. And Kyle Sonnenberg cranks things up in his own zone. Sonnenberg splits a man. Sonnenberg's wrist shot. Stopped by guy. The rebound is lying in front. Sonnenberg picks it up in the high slot. Circles back. Wrist shot. Boyer tipped that one just wide of the net. I don't know if Boyer tipped it or just hit him. It just missed the far post. Nolly tries to pinch that one up, but it was knocked out by Kevin George. Sonnenberg does a good job coming across the ice to recover for Molly, who pinched. Sonnenberg's pass ramped up off a stick and back to Noyes. To Whalen. Whalen just chips that one in, goes for a change. Down to 1 minute remaining now in this first period. Now Kurt Hill. Touch pass off the boards. Hill waits for a man. It's Thorner coming off the bench. Couldn't connect on the pass. Down low to Thorner again. He couldn't get a shot away. Good defensive back check there by Spalling, lifting a stick, and the Ridgebacks are away 2-on-2. Wise, his wrist shot is stopped. Blocked on the way through. The Warriors turn it back the other way. 2-on-2 of their own. Boyer will just dump it in, and Thorner will go after the forecheck himself. Back into the neutral zone. This is Whiteley. His pass behind Lewicki, and Wise picks that one off. Baker over the line, shot. Rising shot, hit a stanchion, came out the other way. Sharp angle shot off the side of the net. Hardigan had no idea where that one was. Back the other way come the Warriors. It's Lewicki. Backhand pass. That was behind Hill. It's here with 6 seconds left, and Baker will have to pass it up. He'll just dump it into the corner. And Hardigan dodging a bullet in the last minute, so the Warriors will go into the first intermission ahead 2-0.
Yeah, and this Ridgeback team will have some adjustments to make. I'm sure they've seen a lot of what the Warriors can throw at them here. Really seems to me they're having a lot of trouble containing the cycle and with that pinching defenseman on the cycle. So they'll have some things to talk about. We saw a few good shifts from there. I noticed probably between the 5 and the 3 minute mark of that last period, they did string together some sustained pressure. And Adam, it wasn't golden opportunities or anything like that, but I think that that would be a good starting point for them and something to focus on, because when the puck is in the Waterloo end, obviously you don't have to worry about their cycle and their offensive game. And I think if the Ridgebacks focus on that, getting some sustained pressure, hanging on to that puck, and then they'll eventually draw a penalty and start to get some momentum in this game.
And in the meantime, the Warriors are going to look to build on their 2-0 lead after one period. We'll take a break and we'll be back for the start of the second. After one, it's the Warriors 2, the Ridgebacks no score. Welcome back, getting set for second period action here at the Columbia Icefields on the north campus of the University of Waterloo. Score after one period, the Waterloo Warriors 2, the UOIT Ridgebacks no score. My name's Adam McGuire, with me is Mark McCamey. We're on the streaming sports network, ssncanada.ca. Before we get going with our second period here, let's take a trip around the OUA out-of-town scoreboard. Midway through the second period, Carleton up in Ottawa, hosting Concordia and leading the Stingers 4-2. McGill leads UQTR in a battle of the top two teams in the OUA's Eastern Conference. They lead 2-0 past the midway point of the second period. Brock, ahead of Lakehead up in Thunder Bay today, 1-0 after one period of play. Toronto, 2-1 leaders after one period over Ryerson. RMC trails Nipissing 3-1, early stages of the second period. The Guelph Griffins are ahead after one period over the Laurier Golden Hawks, 1-0. And perhaps the most surprising scoreline thus far, although it's only after one period, the Windsor Lancers ahead of the Western Mustangs, 2-0. Shots in that game are 17-3. Windsor. Western, of course, is the number one team in the OUA West. They have one regulation loss the entirety of the 2010-11 season. Our score here is 2-0 Waterloo. And Mark, I would imagine that there would be a tale of two stories in the dressing rooms after one period. The Warriors with a message of continue to put the foot to the pedal. And for the UOT Ridgebacks, it's probably something more along the lines of build on our 3 to 5 minutes of solid play and try to get a goal early on.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, these Warriors, you couldn't ask for much more in that period there. Just a lot of great cycling and using their defensemen, a lot of great pressure. It seems like a lot of positive things in that dressing room, and they don't want to let up on this UIOT team who is known to play good teams very tight. And some positives, so you have to try to draw some positives out of that period at least, and there were for this Ridgeback team who had some good shifts where they slowed down this Waterloo forecheck and slowed down that cycle by getting their own offensive in and holding possession of that puck, not trying to put it on net too hastily and generating some offense that way. So they'll look to try to do some more of that, I would assume, and get back into this game.
Right off the opening face-off of this second period, the Ridgebacks into the Warriors' zone. This is Vatry. Vatry looking for a passing lane. Noise at the point. A stop there, the rebound. Good defensive play by Chris Ray, knocking the rebound away, and now Ray comes on a 2-on-1 with Moyer. Ray has Moyer. Ray holds to Moyer! Just wide of the net. The defenseman got a stick on that on the way through, tapped it just out of the reach of Tyler Moyer. He didn't get all of it. Ray keeps it in at the line. Wrist shot, sharp angle, stopped by Jason Guy. Now Schwendy in on the forecheck. Cycles it down low for Moyer. Around the net, tries to center it for Ray. Fanned on that pass. Skated away there by Bergshaw. Behind the net now, and Schwendy steals it from Noyes. Schwendy tried to center it in front. Loose puck there. Smith, he's got 2 points so far tonight. Smith, his pass back to the line, and Whiteley couldn't keep it in. Back to the center ice red line, and into his own zone he retreats. Pass to Schaffert. Smith now picks this one up. Smith going in on the forecheck. The Smith-Schaffert-Chartier line, a line full of first-year Waterloo Warriors, on fire thus far tonight. Accounted for both goals. Smith tried to send that one to Chartier, who was streaking. Back to the center ice red line it comes, and Sonnenberg into Schaffert. Schaffert overskated that puck. Behind the net, Chartier couldn't center it. Ties up his man, Noyes. Schaffert now. Sonnenberg pinches in, backhands it behind the net. Schaffert is the first one there. Sonnenberg tried to kick that up to his stick and couldn't do it. And finally, the Ridgebacks will have a chance to skate it out. Flipped ahead by George. A long lead pass the other way and a 3-on-2 for the Warriors. Schaffert cuts to the center of the ice. Chartier tipped that one just wide. Schaffert knocked off the puck there. Chartier couldn't find it in his feet. He's dead tired. He was looking to go off on a change. Had to play the puck first. Now hammered the length of the ice, and icing is the call. Matt Pastor just wound up and smack that one down the ice to get a change.
You can tell some frustration from Noyes and Pastor there, as they weren't allowed to get off, even though their offensive players had some opportunities to get the puck deep. The long change here in the second period, just a marathon shift for them. So they'll get off and get some rest here as this UIO team struggles with the Warrior forecheck once again.
Puck behind the net. This is Wise for the Ridgebacks. Down to Baker. To Spaulding. It has been Baker, Spaulding, and Wise that have caused the most trouble for the Warriors in their own zone. Just nothing yet to show for it from the Ridgebacks. Warriors continue to lead 2-0. Now Baker gets the return feed. Baker, backhand pass to Spaulding, broken up there. One too many passes perhaps from the Ridgebacks, and a back-checking play by Kurt Hill knocked that one away from Nathan Spaulding before he got it in the high slot. Baker now through the center of the ice, knocked down. Wise overskated it. The other way now come the Warriors, knocked back into the Warrior zone. Delayed offside is the call. And Sonnenberg coughed that one up, but the linesman is saying ice or offside, excuse me. The Ridgebacks did not clear the zone on the long change. Faceoff will come all the way down into the UOIT zone. Faceoff won there by Montgomery for the Ridgebacks. Jeff Barletta up ahead to Ryan Oliver. Stepped around his man. This will be a penalty to the Warriors. He was upended. Montgomery shot off the crossbar. A rising shot, blocker side, Hartigan hardly moved on that rocket, off the crossbar out of play, and the Ridgebacks will have their first power play opportunity.
Yeah, just what the doctor ordered for this Ridgeback team here, a power play after struggling in the early parts of this period with the Warriors' top two lines going to work in their offensive zone, and perhaps getting a little confidence off that last shot off the crossbar, beating Keaton Hartigan. They'll look to get some shots on him this period, something they haven't been able to do a lot of this game, and you'd like to think they'd put some traffic in front of the net and just wire some pucks here.
Faceoff won by Chris Ray. Whiteley to Thorner, he got it mixed up in the skates of the official, couldn't clear it. Corey Frazier got the tripping penalty. The UIT Ridgebacks power play goes to work. This is Pastor. Long wrister stopped there by Hartigan, laid in front of him for a moment. No presence in front of the net by the Ridgebacks, and Whiteley is skating that one out easily. Whiteley now leading the rush shorthanded. Steve Whiteley's sharp angle shot bounces right back to him. Will smartly play it into the corner and take a spot back on the point. Now this is George on the rush. Stepped around Ray. Chris Ray now chips it past Mike Noyes in the length of the ice. Jason Guy will set this one up. Vasey is there in the forecheck. Pastor will play it on the breakout for the Ridgebacks. Up ahead to Wettering. Kyle Wettering into the corner. Backhanded around the net by Hartigan. Stopped along the boards. Kept in there by Purvis. Good play there by the Ridgebacks D-man. And Moorkirk, he hammers Molly off the puck. Wettering is down low too. Wrap around chance now in front. No one was there. Van Moorkirk sent that one through the crease. Purvis to Baker, one-timer. That one was blocked. Cardiff to the line. Knocked down by Baker. Kept in. Loose puck now. Purvis will be the first one there. His shot kicked away by Hartigan through traffic. Baker keeps it into George. Off the boards comes George looking for the down low. Give and go. Can't have it. In front of the net. Stop. The rebound. Didn't get through. Van Moorkirk had the second shot. And offside is the call. With 9 seconds left in the Ridgebacks power play.
Yeah, the 9 seconds left here. Probably not much of an opportunity to set up, but some real positives there on that last shift. Ridgebacks were really digging in on the boards and getting possession of that puck and had a good sequence there just because of that. So they'll look to carry that momentum coming off this power play.
Shot in. Hartigan stopped that for Whiteley. off the boards to the line, and now out into the neutral zone. Penalty over. Warriors kill off the first penalty of the game. Will go a long way into reestablishing themselves as the best penalty-killing team in the OUA. Laurier had just jumped past them by percentage points. Oliver shot short side. Blocker saved by Hartigan. Lewicki now over center ice. His shot off of Legg and into the corner. TJ Legg is there. Thorner knocked it to Hill. Jeremy Whalen tries to make a move. Tied up with Lewicki along the half boards. And flipped the length of the ice by Barletta, but it's knocked down at center ice by Whiteley. Hill now, he's rubbed out by Legg. Hill kicks it ahead. Sonnenberg streaking to the net, couldn't find the pass. There was a lane there, but Hill couldn't see him. Sonnenberg, always dangerous, jumping off the point in the offensive zone. And Cowardine. We see some more frustration in the UOIT bench. This is Chartier. Down to Schappert, misplayed that. Rizzi's the first one there, but Schappert bought enough time for the Warriors to get back and establish defensive presence in the neutral zone. Now Sonnenberg, battery on him. Sonnenberg shakes him off, makes a pass to Molly. Molly up ahead, now for a streaking Sonnenberg. Sonnenberg in, 2-on-1, centers it. Knocked away, good defensive play there by Matt Pastore. Now an odd man rush the other way. Battery to the net, stopped. A sprawling play. There will be a penalty on that one. Derek Bagshaw was going to the net, sprawled out, and trying to eliminate the odd man rush with Chartier, and he got a stick involved and took a hooking penalty.
Yeah, when you look at a player like Kyle Sonnenberg, who is invaluable to this Warrior team and makes a fantastic play there to join the rush for a 2-on-1, the other players on the ice in exchange for that have to recognize and come back to support him as he goes up in an offensive role. And in that play, Chartier was just a step behind, and the Ridgebacks take advantage.
Chartier for hooking is the call. Just short of the 8-minute mark here in the second period. 2-0, the Warriors continue to lead. Spalling. Download of Atri. To Pastore at the point. Shot kicked away. Blocked by Whiteley. To Thorner. Flips it. Had a streaking Chris Ray going for a shorthanded break. Couldn't reach him. Now bouncing puck in front of the net. Ray spins and fires. Clears it. Jason Guy tries to prevent the Warriors from making the long change in this second period. Whiteley's the first one there. Rolling puck. Now Chris Ray played that one ahead. And a smart play by Kurt Thorner to drop it back to Cowardine and clear it once again. The Ridgebacks having problems retaining possession in the offensive zone on this, their second power play of the night. Wettering up ahead to Van Moerkerk. Van Moerkerk, he tried to center it. Cowardine made a big play there, breaking that pass up to the line, but knocked down by Baker. Kept in. Down low Bagshaw. Behind the net. Looking for something to set up. He's got Van Moerkerk in front, but he's got no passing lane. Off the boards to Purvis. Purvis to Baker. Just kept that one in. Whiteley's the first one there. Didn't play the puck in front. Just wide through the crease. Purvis now. Back of the net. Van Moerkerk. Whiteley. Well, Van Moerkerk comes away with the puck. Tries to play it back down to Bagshaw, and Whiteley stepped between him and the puck. Plays it to the... He's able to clear the puck to center ice first. Now Baker. Frazier loses an edge, so Baker's got to jump on him. Back to Van Moerkerk. In front. Now behind the net. Over the stick of Van Moerkerk. Penalty just about expired. In front. Blocked. Shot. Again. Chartier's out of the box, and Whiteley plays it up ahead to him, off the glass and out of play. Penalty is over, and just 24 for this one, the Warriors kill off another one.
Yeah, great job by this Warrior team here on the penalty kill. That's something they're known for and something they pride themselves on. And we continue to hear the frustrations over on this Ridgeback bench, rather, who some of the players just really grinding their... They want to win this game, obviously, and want to get some offense going, but really having a trouble getting pucks on Keaton Hartigan.
Off to center ice, Thorner. Cross ice, dump in. Hill battles with Barletta there. Kurt Hill is the first one. Whalen in the wiki. Sonnenberg kept it in twice and bats it into the corner. Now the Warriors back off on the forecheck a little bit. Here comes Whalen for the Ridgebacks. Whalen, Sonnenberg, his almost had that puck and had the chance for an odd man rush. Couldn't corral it. Now Montgomery over the line. Wrist shot, glove save. For the hook, and so the Warriors will go to their second power play of the game, having
the key is for the Warriors here to having been able to fend off the majority of this Ridgeback offense on the gas. They can't let up the midway point of this game. And can't see their lead dissipate. So that would be the message I would expect to hear.
Play. So we'll do the face-off again. Ray and Spalling lead in. The two captains against one another. Once again, won by Spalling. Office right away. Down into the Warrior zone, it's Kyle Sonnenberg. Sonnenberg will represent Canada in the World University Games coming up at the end of January in Turkey, along with Chris Ray. The Warriors. Once again, the Warriors having trouble sustaining pressure to start this power play out. Already 35 seconds off of the penalty. To Vatry. Now Kurt Hill to Sonnenberg. Over to Whiteley. Whiteley down to Moyer. Moyer back to the high point. It's Sonnenberg to Whiteley. Down to Moyer. Across to Sonnenberg. Walks in. Shoots. That's a stop there by Guy. Out of the corner. Hill pokes it one-handed back to Sonnenberg. Kept that one in at the line. Once again, puck kept in. By Sonnenberg. Cross, loose puck in front. They shoot. Big Jason Guy stacking the pads and stopped the bouncing puck. Moyer had that chance. Over the line now comes in front. Schaffer to Thorner. Couldn't finish that one. Ray tried to center that one. Schaffer's the first one there into the corner. Back to Whiteley at the point. Whiteley had that one hop on him. Cross the ice to his partner Sonnenberg. Sonnenberg to Ray, chips that one up over the glass and out of play. For a faceoff outside the UOIT zone, 21 seconds remaining in the power play.
Well, Guy with another great save. As we expected, he would have to be sharp in this game for the Ridgebacks to have a shot at it, and him trying to give his team the best shot now. And another outstanding play by Sonnenberg to keep that puck in, and good vision by Chris Ray to put it through there on that play, but Guy is equal to the task.
Ryan Molly. Now Smith with it in the corner. Across to Cowardine. Thorner in front. Thorner gets the chance there. Chipped it just over the net. Guy might have gotten a piece of that. Penalty is now over. Vatry came out of the box and they had a man behind the D, but Molly intercepted the pass. Now Leg, his outlet pass to Vatry. Battery leads the rush for the Ridgebacks. Has Baker. Battery crossed up with Baker. Still has the puck. Connor's off the bench. Schaffer blocked that shot. Up ahead to Thorner, and Thorner's out of gas. Puck back into the Warriors' zone. And the Warriors will complete a change. Smith leaves that one for Cardiff. Cardiff jumps past his man and dumps it in, but it's right on the goaltender Guy, who will hold for a faceoff. 6:56 remaining, second period. Score remains 2-0 Warriors. They had the first two quick ones of the game early on in the first period. They've held on since then. Face-off to the right of Jason Guy, OHL veteran. Played for three teams in the Ontario Hockey League. Most recently, the London Knights and the Guelph Storm. Over the line now, center ice, it's Van Moorkirk. He had that one knocked off his stick. Comes right back to him. Now Cardiff, he was sent flying as he stepped up trying to intercept the pass. Knocked it down in the neutral zone and shot it back in. Basie clears the zone, so Frazier comes in on the forecheck. Bounce pass all the way to center ice to Sonnenberg. Chartier tips that one in for Lewicki. In front, bouncing puck to the high slot. Sonnenberg now to Cowardine. His shot cross ice. Chartier tried to center it. As a man streaking to the net, it's Hill. That puck was just behind him. And it shot the length of the ice. And for icing against the UOIT Ridgebacks, 5:54 remaining in the second period.
Well, what's really impressive to me, Adam, is as I mentioned before, it's easy to get sucked in at times like this when your opponent isn't generating a lot of offensive and a lot of threat to get sucked into being complacent and sitting back a bit. And I don't think this Warrior team's done that. You saw in that last play, Lewicki just go all out on the forecheck there on a play where he was able to get a turnover and get the offense throughout that shift. So that's really important, and the Warriors are doing a good job of that thus far.
Off the face-off, a shot through traffic by Whiteley was wide off the end boards. Nobody could reach it. Now up ahead, it's Oni Rizzi. Smacks that one into the Warrior zone. Long pass just out of Hill's reach, but he wasn't able to get a stick on it. Thought he did for a moment. Icing is the call against the Warriors. We are live from the Columbia Icefields of the University of Waterloo's North Campus. Adam McGuire with Mark McCamey. We're on the Streaming Sports Network, SSNCanada.ca. 2-0 here, late second period. The Warriors. Backs. This is Sean Connors. Played that one up through center ice. Now jumping ahead is Ray. He's got a man streaking to the net. It's Schwendy. He just couldn't handle that one. The pass was a little behind him, and he couldn't handle it. Streaking to the net. Once again, incredible vision there by the captain, Chris Ray. Gloved ahead. Wise played that glove pass. So the faceoff will come back into the Ridgeback zone. We mentioned the World University Games. Also going and representing Canada and the Warriors is the general manager of that club, which is Brian Burke, the head coach of the University of Waterloo Warriors. That means assistant coach Jordan Brenner will step behind the bench for three games later this month and early in February. Cowardine, an ill-advised dive at the line to keep that one in. Now a 2-on-1. Bagshaw in front. Stop there. Big save. Coming across on the butterfly. Now another shot. Hartigan stopped that one too. It was tipped just wide. Purvis' third shot tipped high and wide. Puck off the side of the net now. Also some sustained pressure for the Ridgebacks, who are still only down by two. Schwendy tried to feed that one to Ray. Moyer also at center ice. Knocks that one ahead. It's turned back by Purvis. Chris Purvis had Tony Rizzi. He was not able to corral that puck. Now the other way come the Ridgebacks. Battery was creeping in with Rizzi, but offside is the call.
Really positive shift there for the Ridgebacks against the Warriors' top line, led by Captain Chris Ray, who throughout this game has really hemmed in the UIOT Ridgebacks through pretty well every shift they've had thus far. So a positive shift there for them, being in the offensive zone, and perhaps a morale-boosting shift moving forward.
To center ice, this is TJ Legg. Backs. Whiteley is there first to Steffes. Over to Schappert. He's got Chartier. Bounce pass just a little too far for Chartier. Once again, this is the Warriors' first year line. Chartier, Schappert, and Smith, all rookies. These Warriors, they've accounted for both goals tonight. They've looked tremendous. All kinds of chances aside from the two goals that they potted. Chartier, his hit on Legg. Legg spins away from that. Bounce pass too far there for George, and will go the length of the ice for icing. 3:25 remaining in this second period. You mentioned it, Mark. The Warriors can't afford to take their foot off the pedal, and we've often heard the adage that the two-goal lead is perhaps the most difficult in hockey, the most dangerous. One goal and the UOIT Ridgebacks are right back in it, but another one for the Warriors, and it would be hard for the Ridgebacks at this point to climb out of that three-goal hole. The next goal, extremely important. Howard Ein to Molly. Fan on that first attempt. Gets it past forechecking Baker. Center ice, Wise. That one sent right back to Vasey. Molly to Cowardine. Up ahead, Colin Fraser. This is the energy line for the Warriors. Fraser with Vasey on the forecheck. Vasey lays his man out after he played the puck. That was Matt Pastore. Over the line, Warriors wanted an offside call. Didn't get it. But no harm because the puck flipped back into the UOIT zone as the Warriors make a change. Baker and Spalling. Spalling just in ahead over the line. And Baker rips the puck off the boards in frustration.
I think it was Wise in offside in that period. He was just making a change. He took a hard hit there by two Warrior players, and he is walking it off behind the bench now.
Right, that was Wise on the near boards. One of the quirks of this old barn with the penalty boxes and benches on the same side, the benches stretch perhaps a little further into the offensive zones than they normally would. In the second period especially, you see a lot of changes that actually force an offside situation. Rizzi now to Bagshaw. Bagshaw shot off Sonnenberg's stick and high over the glass and out of play. 2 minutes and 2 seconds remaining in the second period. 2-0 is the score.
A really great movement on that play by the Ridgebacks. Able to get the puck up the ice really quick on a series of close to one-touch passes. But I've noticed a lot in this game. They're able to get the puck down, and just when they're ready to have a shot on net, it's either blocked or they're steered away or whatever happens. It seems to be at the end of the play. They just can't seem to finish.
In front of the net, two saves by Hartigan. Off a face-off, it just dribbled to the front of the net. Nobody was able to play it away, and Hartigan made a save on Wettering. Now Noyes misplayed that one and hopped over his stick, and it went out center ice, so the Ridgebacks have to clear. Now Whalen, his shot stopped. The rebound in front. Cleared away by the Warriors. Another sharp-angle shot by Whalen. Excuse me, that was Wettering. Now tipped right on by George, kicked away by the right pad of Hartigan. Noyes now, his shot through traffic, wide of the net, off the end boards. Chris Ray up to Moyer, now to Schwendy. Schwendy by himself, waiting for help. That's Moyer now jumping in. Back to the point, Cowardine, he fanned on that one. Noyes plays the puck up to Baker. Scott Baker, his shot, sharp angle, stopped by Hardigan, no rebound. Frozen for a faceoff in the Warrior zone.
Well, great shift there by the Whalen-George Ruttering line. They come off to a little more lively bench, and those are the kind of shifts and kind of morale-boosting shifts that this Ridgeback team needs, and hopefully they're able to carry that to the end of this period and really have something to focus on at the break here. Some positives to take with them and to talk about and how they can break down this Warrior team.
106 remaining in this second period. Face off in the Warrior zone. Scrum draw. Baker, quick shot off a stick. Went high over Keaton Hardigan's head and missed the crossbar. Now Vasey. He's got a step. Vasey to the outside. Tried to slip it in. Short side on Guy. He wasn't biting. Bounce pass off the side of the net now. That one's intercepted as well. Whipped. Sonnenberg. Over to Molly. Played it ahead to Vasey. Vasey didn't cross the center ice red line before he dumped that one in, though. So icing against the Warriors with 37 seconds left. Off the draw, Thorner up ahead, plays it to center ice. Shot right back into the Warrior zone. Sonnenberg to Molly. One touch pass to Hill, he couldn't handle it. Now Sonnenberg. 15 seconds left, that pass out of the reach of Kurt Hill, and it will go for icing. So with 13 seconds left, the Ridgebacks maybe try to quickly set up a faceoff play to get a quick chance or two towards Keaton Hardigan and try to get one before the end of the second period.
Yeah, you see Spaulding hop out immediately there, and you can tell he's intent on taking that draw and as they set this one up. And
Spaulding's been dynamite on the faceoff circle. And scrummed and taken away by the Warriors, Cowardine. Up to Thorner. Thorner's happy with just pinning it along the sideboards as the period expires. So no scoring in that second period of play. The Warriors continue to lead 2-0, and heading into the third period of play, Mark, I imagine the Ridgebacks will try to continue to build on what they have to think would be a successful second period. They had their opportunities and some timely saves by Keaton Hardigan and some bad bounces perhaps kept them off the scoreboard.
Yeah, absolutely. There were flashes there for sure, Adam, and I guess you kind of have to have selective amnesia here because a lot of frustrations throughout this game too. You know, you see some positives towards the end, which is really good for the Ridgeback squad, but you'd have to make sure, and hopefully the leaders in the room are really focusing on those positives because you saw some frustrated players, and that would really, really not help them for this third period. So hopefully they're able to focus on that. And as you say, there were some great chances on Hardigan, and he had to be good on those. Not a lot of shots, but timely saves, as we mentioned. And it looks to be an exciting third period. I don't expect this Ridgeback team to go away. That's not something that they've pride themselves on, and not something that they do. So the Warriors will have to, as we mentioned before, not get complacent and come out hard as well.
Absolutely. So after two periods of play, the score, the Waterloo Warriors 2, the UOIT Ridgebacks no score. We'll take a break and be back for the third period of play. Welcome back to the Columbia Icefields on the north campus of the University of Waterloo. Getting set for the third period of play. The Waterloo Warriors lead the UOIT Ridgebacks 2-0 before we get set. And going here, let's take a trip around the OUA out-of-town scoreboard. Start of the third period in Toronto, in Kingston, RMC trails Nipissing 4-2. In Toronto, the Blues, Varsity Blues, ahead of the Ryerson Rams 3-2 after two periods of play. McGill up 3-0 late on the UQTR Patriot. Lakehead has taken the lead from Brock up in Thunder Bay. It's 2-1 now, late second period there. Western and Windsor knotted up at 2. Going into the third period there, Windsor out shooting Western 29-17 in that one. Laurier, the Golden Hawks trail the Guelph Griffins 3-2 late in the second period. And your score here, the Waterloo Warriors 2, the UOIT Ridgebacks, no score. Shots after two periods, UOIT 22 and Waterloo 21. And Mark, the Ridgebacks led in the shots on goal department in that second period. And I think that'd be something that they would build on in the intermission.
Yeah, a lot of positives there. And they were able to get some pucks at Hartigan. He's been strong this game when he has had to be. And it'll just be a morale thing, I think, with this team. We're close enough that we can see on their benches a lot of frustration. And I mentioned that at the end of last period as a bit of a concern. But I'm sure they've had a period to settle down, and the leaders on this team will get them back on track, drawing off a positive last 5 minutes in that second period. And it should be a battle here for these Warriors to try to hold their lead.
Away we go in the third period. Right away, the clearing attempt blocked there. Rizzi in front. Puck knocked off the stick of Derek Bagshaw. Ridgebacks now. Still with the pressure on Rizzi. In front of the net. That one's wide. Rizzi has it again. Fending off the check of Colin Cowardine. Schwendy is in there too. Ray tries to pick it out of the pile of legs. Can't quite do it. Back behind the net. It will slide. Vaitre and Whiteley battle for it. Whiteley knocked that one off of Vaitre's stick. And Bagshaw played that puck over the line before the Ridgebacks cleared the zone, so offside is a call.
A good start for the Ridgebacks. Just an offensive pressure shift there. Not really getting any pucks at net, but they're keeping possession nonetheless. And what that does is immediately neutralizes the very effective Waterloo forecheck and cycle game, which they've done very well so far this game.
Sonnenberg behind the net. Bounce pass to Thorner. Thorner slides that one past Connors, is there on the forecheck. Purvis is back behind the net too. Puck slides to the blue line, knocked in there by Wong, but skated out by George. Keelan Wong knocked George just off stride enough to force offside as Jeremy Whalen was in just over the line. Haven't seen much of Keelan Wong. As per the usual, Sonnenberg and Whiteley seeing the bulk of the minutes on the back end for the Warriors. Whalen now behind the net looking for a man out in front. Nobody there. Back to the point. Connors' wrist shot through a crowd right in front of Hartigan. He'll freeze it. Couldn't find it. Hartigan couldn't find that puck, and it was lying right at his feet. He covered it up for the whistle.
Immediately following that play, Adam, you can hear this OUIT Ridgeback squad on the bench just up and ready to go, cheering on their teammates here. They talked it over, obviously, throughout the period, and they're ready to come at these Warriors in this game with a good start, first couple shifts, and getting some pucks on Hartigan.
There's another shot right through the traffic and was kicked away into the slot by Hartigan. Nobody could reach the rebound. It was lying right there in the slot at the top of the crease. TJ Legg now. Back to Barletta. Jeff Barletta plays that to Baker. Scott Baker dumps that in. Behind the net, Hartigan stops it. Has that puck stolen. Knocked right to Ryan Molly, and he'll find Mike Vasey streaking through center ice. He'll play it back to Molly. The Ridgebacks cramming up this neutral zone now, making it difficult for the Warriors to move through. Finally, Vasey gains the blue line into the UOIT zone. Into the attacking zone for the first time for the Warriors. Barletta gathers it behind his own net. Is that one up to Wise along the end boards? And icing is the call against the Ridgebacks. 17:45 remaining in the third period. 2-0 is our score. My name's Adam McGuire. With me is Mark McCamey, and we are on the streaming sports network, SSNCanada.ca. Faceoff, one there by Smith and Shepard. Smith, Shepard, and Chartier on again. Tip right there, blocker save. The wrist shot by Whiteley. Chartier got a piece of it, and Guy was able to knock it away with his elbow. Now Noyes. Smith stepped up on him. Noyes gathers it in his own zone. Long seam pass there. Van Moerkirk had a bit of a step, and his backhand pass went wide. Smith behind his own net. Turns back to Whiteley. Whiteley to Shepard. He can't chip it out. Pastor keeps that one in. Now down low to Oliver. Oliver's shot. That one fluttered wide of the net. Didn't get all of that one. Oliver now behind the net. That one was poked away from him by Steffes to Whiteley. Over Purvis's stick. And icing is the call. The Warriors bench doesn't like that call. Thought Purvis maybe played that one at the blue line, but icing is the call against the Warriors.
And a much better job this period already. You can see the change in the Ridgebacks' attitude and hustle and a lot more possession in the offensive zone, which has given them a lot of confidence on their bench and really jump-starting them for this period.
Off the face-off, chip pass, Purvis. He went down as he tried to throw a pick after he had the puck chip past him. He's very slow back to the bench. Moyer up ahead to Ray. Puck behind him. Ray's got Schwendi and Moyer in front. Schwendi puck just over his stick. Molly's shot now. The rolling puck in front. The rebound. Backhander. Ray is stopped. That's Schwendi on the rebound as well. And Guy covers up. Schwendi had two chances on the backhand rebound from Molly. And Jason Guy made the save.
Ray taking advantage there of forward having to play defense, I believe it was. I'm not sure. Purvis had to leave the ice there after getting injured on the play. And the Ridgeback player a little bit late coming in. But in any case, Ray comes in, makes a nice play. The puck just missed. And a nice pushback by the Warriors' top line there.
Face-off controlled by the Ridgebacks. This is TJ Legg. Flips it high. Controlled there by Molly. Up to Thorner. Thorner in front. Off the side of the net. Right out in front. Thorner gets it back himself. Shoots it just high and wide over the net. Now Legg. Backhands that one down behind the Waterloo goal line. Puck bashed in behind the Waterloo net, but the Ridgebacks have to clear on the offside. Now back in on the forecheck. Aggressive and looking for turnovers now. Trying to spark a offensive chance. Vasey dumped that one in. Ray. Frazier, he leveled his man, and Ray lifts a stick, allowing Vasey to keep that one into the line. But it's played back out. Connors takes a long shot right into the chest of Keaton Hartigan. He'll hold for a faceoff. 15:13 remaining in this third period. Still 2-0 Warriors.
Now, as you mentioned there on that last shift, Adam, a real aggressive forecheck we're seeing here from the Ridgeback squad, recognizing that they do have to start gaining some momentum and getting some solid opportunities, and that's something we haven't seen quite the jump that they have this period. We haven't seen for the previous parts of this game.
Chris Ray winds it up in his own zone, puff in the feet of Moyer. And it's returned to the Warriors' zone by UOIT. Now Ray hits center ice. Dumps it in all the way around the side of Schwendi. Had that pop over his stick. Ray recovers. Floats it for Whiteley. Off the line, Whiteley shot. Stopped by Guy and a penalty coming up. I believe it'll be against the Ridgebacks. And it won't be. It will be to the Warriors. Chris Ray will take the high sticking penalty, I think.
Yeah, it'll be Ray with the high stick there with the puck up at the point in the Ridgeback zone. Ray made a play to pass it across the line and did so successfully, but brought his stick up in the process and got Baker in the face, and Baker made sure the official saw it.
To the Warriors, to the penalty kill. They are a perfect 2-for-2 in the penalty kill so far tonight. The Wiki now on the forecheck separated his man from the puck momentarily. Now went over the line, long wrist shot. That one was wide, bounced off the end boards. Now Wettering behind the net. For the Ridgebacks, Wettering looking for a passing lane. Instead just lays it back down across the crease, pass off the side of the net. Van Moerkirk had a chance, but he rifled it off the side of the net. He was waiting on that back post. Now the shoot-in backhanded away by Whiteley to Thorner. Kurt Thorner. Thorner over the line. Thorner, wrist shot just wide. Basie smacks that one towards the net. Thorner in front. Had the stick lifted. Didn't get all of that shot. Thorner always dangerous. Even on the penalty kill, he is tied for the OUA lead in shorthanded goals. Now Baker. Up ahead, backhanded in by Matt Pastor. Puck loose, high, slot. Couldn't handle that one. That was Wise that had that one bounce over his stick. Now battling for it is Spalling. Loses that battle. Molly comes away with it. Thorner dumped to the length of the ice. Guy played it up quickly. Now Josh Vatry lays it back at the line for Pastor. Off the boards comes Wise. Wise had that one poked away by Tyler Moyer and out. 15 seconds left now in the Chris Rea penalty. Turnover again at the red line, and Tyler Moyer tries to clear that one out, but Pastor kept that in momentarily. Now cleared the length of the ice, and the Warriors' power play, penalty kill, moves to 3-for-3.
Outstanding job by the Warriors' penalty kill this game. That's been a huge part of it, and it'll be something we'll have to keep in mind at the end of this game.
Could be the difference for sure. Now Hill over the line for the Warriors. Hill, sharp angle shot off the blocker. Knocked right down in front. Now back to Cowardine. Whiteley at the point. Long shot, wide of the net. Penalty coming up to the Ridgebacks. Delayed call, and it will be a slash. And I believe the penalty will be to Ryan Oliver. A little discussion now if they've got the right man or not. It is Oliver. 2 minutes for slashing, so the Warriors go back to the power play. 12:15 remaining, third period.
A bit of a punch in the gut for the Ridgeback team, who saw their opportunity there to get back on the or to get on the board for the first time this game in that last power play for them. They saw that dissipate with a very effective Waterloo kill, and now the Warriors have their opportunity to put this game, one might think, out of reach.
It is Whalen, in fact. They just took Oliver out of the penalty box, put Whalen in there. Whalen for slashing, and right off the opening faceoff, the Ridgebacks clear the zone. Kyle Sonnenberg up ahead to Smith. Smith holds and waits. Smith around back of the net, still with the puck, to Sonnenberg. Sonnenberg returns it to Smith. Smith down low. Schappert. Schappert holding. Tried to throw it back to Smith. Couldn't quite connect with that pass, and it's cleared the length of the ice. Warriors got a little congested on one side of the ice and couldn't spread the puck around in the power play. Now Whiteley over center ice to Smith in front. Trailer, Schwendy, he collided with his own man Whiteley. And that allows Van Moerkirk an easy clear and flip down into the corner south of the Warriors' goal line. Sonnenberg now under a minute remaining in the power play to Ray. Chris Ray back to Sonnenberg. Sonnenberg, Pastor had knocked that one off his stick. Far post, the pass back to Whiteley. Now to Moyer. Tyler Moyer Cross ice to Sonnenberg. Sonnenberg flipped it into the corner to Shepard. The Warriors having a little bit of trouble here with the aggressive penalty kill of the Ridgebacks. Sonnenberg settles it down at the line. Low shot, kicked away there, blocked in front by Barletta. Now Barletta will have a chance and clear the puck the length of the ice and out. Long pass there by Keaton Hartigan to Ray. Ray bounced that one off the board, sidestep to check. 15 seconds left in the power play now. Giveaway behind the UOIT net by the goaltender guy. Moyer tried to center it, and it'll just bounce right to Josh Vatry. And he will clear the zone, and the penalty will expire. Offside, delayed offside, so Wettering can't touch the puck, but the Ridgebacks kill off the penalty. Nearing the halfway point of this third period. Now Chris Ray over the line. Ray steps to the middle, scores! Chris Ray! 3-0 Warriors.
Well, after an impressive Ridgeback kill there, a really, really impressive kill, I thought, where they kept the Warriors to the outside the entire time. Chris Ray puts the dagger in the heart, and a really demoralizing goal after you see this Ridgeback team, and you hear, rather, some energy on their bench coming off that kill. So a really tough moment for them, and they're going to have to gather all their strength to try to push back now. And now it becomes more wide open, one would think, and a little more of a chance game as they need something to happen quick.
That one has a chance, anyway, to be a dagger-type goal. A good penalty kill for the UOIT Ridgebacks, and just, as you mentioned, seconds after the penalty expired, Chris Ray comes in, cuts to the center of the ice, shoots against the grain, and beats Guy Blocker's side.
That's Ray from Hartigan and Molly at 9:57.
Molly and Hartigan, I believe, got the assists on that goal. Barletta from the point, his wrist shot was blocked. Al Whalen to George. Pastore in deep, battling with Chartier. Pastore comes along with it at the line. His low wrist shot, that one's tapped aside. And Vasey plays it up to Chartier, who's got Frazier. Frazier's long blast, that was a way wide of the net. The Warriors change up as Chartier puts pressure on the forecheck. Long pass, hit Frazier. Offside is the call, though. And so with 9:09 remaining, the Warriors go up 3-0.
And as we mentioned, Adam, it'll be a push game here for the Ridgebacks in the next minutes here. They'll want to get everything they can on net and activate their defensemen as much as possible to try to get a goal and try to even this thing up or begin the path to evening it up in the next few minutes here.
Shot in on Hartigan. He'll freeze that for a face-off. Keaton Hartigan even getting in on the scoring tonight with the assist on that third Waterloo goal. He's been sharp when called upon, and especially in the second period where the Ridgebacks had 16 shots, he stood tall. Whiteley's backhand clearing attempt. Down to Noyes. He'll gather that behind his own net. Kurt Hill putting pressure on him. Almost came away with the steal. Played back carefully to Sean Connors. Now Baker. Pass behind Spaulding. Bounces off the boards. Whiteley gathers that one up. And poked out by Lewicki. Now a low wrist shot stopped and covered by Hartigan for the whistle. 8:18 remaining in the third period. Warriors lead 3-0.
And the guy we haven't talked too much about tonight, Hartigan, as you mentioned, Adam, really, really sharp when he's had to be in this game, and probably didn't give him enough credit coming off that second period. I didn't realize there were 16 shots already, but even on a simple play like that, he just reels in that rebound.
Loose puck. Hartigan battled that one, and it fluttered over his head and out the other side of the crease, dangerously through the blue paint. Now Smith tried to send that one through to Shepard. That was broken up. Stepping up on the play is Barletta. At Barletta. Shoots it in deep. Follows his own shoot in. Out of the open wing. Chartier chips it up. Montgomery batted that one back in. The Warriors will skate it out. Steffes at center ice. Smith bounced over his stick and Montgomery gathers it there for the Ridgebacks. Now Montgomery. Moyer took that one off his stick. Shot right back in by Van Moerkirk and Molly will take it there for the Warriors. Up ahead to Moyer. Guy comes out to play it. Schwendy is right there. Pass right to Moyer. His quick shot didn't get through. That was blocked. Now Schwendy on the backhand. Cycles it down to Ray. To the point, Sonnenberg. His shot tipped in front. Didn't get all the way through. Ray looking for Sonnenberg on the far post. Streaking to the net. Couldn't find him. Sonnenberg kicks it up ahead to his skates and stick and keeps it in the zone momentarily, but it creeps out. And now a two-man break. Battery. He's got Rizzi with him. Battery had the puck knocked off his stick on a tremendous back check there. I believe that was the captain, Chris Ray.
Just a tremendous effort by Captain Ray there. That really can't be understated. When Sonnenberg, a little bit trying to look for the offense a little bit too much, dangling at the line, which he does so well, but in this scenario, a little lackadaisical getting back. Both defensemen get caught, and Chris Ray, with a huge effort to get back, pokes the puck off the Ridgeback player's stick and to the goaltender Hartigan. Even despite the score, just a tremendous effort on that play to save his goaltender on a breakaway opportunity.
Puck fluttered harmlessly to Hartigan, who froze it. Battery perhaps took a little too much time knowing he had Rizzi with him instead of just streaking in and trying to get the chance. Allowing time for Ray to catch up. Clearing attempt kept in by Barletta. His shot cleared away. Stopped by Hartigan. Frazier off the boards. Passed Pastor and he'll have to go back into his own zone to take it. Now 6 minutes, just over 6 minutes remaining in this third period. Barletta's couldn't handle that pass. Whalen is back to calm things down. Barletta's long pass to Wettering. Wettering now to Whalen. Trying to step around his man. Elon Wong is slow getting to the bench. Now Lewicki. One man back. Lewicki, his shot, backhander, was just wide through the crease. Lewicki came in with a hit on Wettering. O'Connor's backhand pass to Wise. And behind the play, Wettering and Lewicki. Looks like they'll both be taken off for coincidental roughing penalties.
Yeah, Lewicki comes out laying the body on the shift and Wettering takes exception. And that speaks to something that I think we talked about earlier this game, Adam, that's despite the score, you'll see this Warrior team for the most part in this game anyways come out like they really need the next goal, and that's been, I think, crucial to their success in this game.
Pass up ahead to Thorner. Chip that pass, Connors. Thorner in a race with it. Loose puck. Moyer tried to center it. Thorner lifted his man's stick. Puck still loose. Noyes will finally settle it down and play it behind his own net to Baker. Thorner and Moyer causing a ruckus on the forecheck. Back of the net, Guy plays it over to Noyes. And now Wise picks that one up, but Shepard picked his pocket. Shepard is right on Baker's tail. Moyer is there as well. Cross-ice pass by Wise. Wise, his shot, wide of the net. Off the end boards, Baker's shot, sharp angle, high and wide. And now Shepard has a chance to skate it away for the Warriors. He's got Moyer and Hill with him. In front, Hill couldn't corral that one. Good defensive play there. Coming back was Jeff Barletta. A long wrist shot in on Hartigan. 4 minutes and 30 seconds now left to play in this third period. Shepard chips it into the red line. Pastor turns and spins. Goes it back into the neutral zone, just out of the reach of Rizzi. Hartigan leaves it there for Ryan Molly. To Shepard. Up ahead to the streaking Smith. Smith, his shot high. Rising shot. Stopped and held by Jason Guy.
Well, certainly crunch time for the Ridgebacks here. You'd expect them to be throwing everything they can at the net with only 4:14 rather left to try to close this three-goal gap. Seemingly impossible goal, but crazier things have happened. So they'll try to be getting down on the Warrior offensive zone as quick as possible here.
Sonnenberg kept it in at the line. Off the end boards, that one. Smith took a whack at that. High over the glass and out of play. Well, the Warriors obviously right in the thick of the race this year, but if this line's performance is any indication, the future is bright as well. Smith, Chartier, and Schappert together have been dynamite tonight. Now Noyes in his own zone, back to leg. Noyes waits for things to set up. Time is now if the Ridgebacks want to put an offensive pressure on the Warriors. Bagshaw is ridden into the boards by Sonnenberg. Chartier, he's taken into the boards hard by Bagshaw, but Ray comes away with the puck. Ray now splits the D-man. Ray in on goal, scores! Chris Ray! A goal of the year candidate puts the Warriors up 4-0.
Another beauty by Chris Ray. No surprise there. Just a burst of speed, a great move, and a great finish. Had an outstanding season so far. Obviously, the captain of this squad and continuing his success, putting the icing on the cake this game, one would expect. And that's one that'll be fun to score. Maybe not the most important goal in his career, but a pretty one nonetheless.
Ray split the D-men, went backhand roof, and the Warriors lead 4-0. Whiteley up ahead to Ray, looking for the hat trick. Ray couldn't settle down the corral and corral the loose puck.
That's Ray from Chartier at 16:44.
Blake Chartier gets his second assist of the game on Ray's second goal. Rister now. Hartigan kicked that one aside. And Moorkirk whacked that towards the net. Whiteley plays it away. 2:30 remaining now. Third period. And there's little to suggest that the result won't be a Warrior win tonight. Whalen sidesteps a check at the blue line. Sidesteps another one. A nice play in front of the net. Chip just wide and high. That one almost spoiled Keaton Hartigan's bid for a clean sheet. Leg now. His pass picked off by Frazier. Frazier chips it in the leg. Leg to Connors, back to leg, hits the red line, will try to shoot it in. Hit some skates and sticks at the red line, and the Warriors play it back out. Schappert reached for that one. Vasey picks that pass off. Away comes Schappert. Lines and fires, kicked away. The rebound cleared the length of the ice. Icing is the call with 1:31 remaining in the third period. Schappert wound that one up and Gaia came out to meet him.
Tough game for goaltender Guy, who's seen a lot of rubber tonight. We saw some really strong play early in this game. Seems the Warriors, Chris Ray in particular, getting to him in the latter parts. Some tough goals and nice plays, so can't fault the goaltender too much in this one. But
Pastor for the Ridgebacks. His shoot in up over the glass and out of play. Some pushing and shoving after the whistle. These teams have seen a lot of each other and will continue to. Molly is getting mugged there, not moving a muscle himself. But he's getting hauled down and had shots thrown at him. Van Moorkirk perhaps trying to send a bit of a message. This is the second game in a matter of 7 days between these two clubs, and they'll play again next weekend. So perhaps the Ridgebacks trying to send a bit of a physical message. Credit there, though, Mark, to Ryan Molly for really not retaliating in a game where he has nothing to gain from a retaliation.
Yeah, absolutely. A smart play by young player Ryan Molly, and just recognizes that there's no advantage for his team or for himself to get engaged in that. So he makes no effort to oblige Van Moerkerk's offer, and he'll be sent off for his efforts, and I'm sure they'll meet again, or one might think later on this season. But in any case, yeah, perhaps a message and a bit of frustration showing to the Ridgeback team.
Ryan Molly, first-year defenseman, certainly no slouch himself in the size department, 6'3 and 200. Former seventh-round selection of the New Jersey Devils was Ryan Molly. Offside is the call there. A minute, 10 seconds remaining in this third period, and the Warriors up 4-0. Some more bad blood after the whistle. George is getting sent off. George looks like he'll got a 10-minute misconduct just as Van Moerkerk did, and Chris Ray pleading with the officials. Doesn't understand why there's no minors called at this point in the game. Whiteley in his own zone, behind his own net. 1 minute remaining now in the third period. Up ahead in the corner. Skipped in. Barletta is knocked off the puck by Chartier.
That's George.
Lewicki and Pastor battle for it. Pastor laying a lumber to Lewicki. He's happy to freeze the puck along the boards. 35 seconds now remaining. Whistle. Puck frozen along the boards. And for the Warriors, Mark, I imagine they just want to make sure they get out of this one without any incidents.
Yeah, plenty of extracurricular here, and just a winding down game here, and absolutely there's no reason for the Warriors to be in this game anymore, and the Ridgebacks for that matter, but they've got bigger fish to fry here coming weekends, and actually tomorrow, I believe, but yeah, they'll just want to get out of this one and get rested up.
Moyer now has Schwendy. Steffes, his long shot in front. Moyer, his rebound was just wide. Guy stopped that one. Puck down into the Warriors' own. Hartigan will go for a skate. Played in the corner to Steffes. 10 seconds now remaining. Whiteley hammers that one off the boards to center ice. And Noyes in his own zone will let the time expire. And Keaton Hartigan comes up with his first shutout of the